Hello all, welcome to this session of openmentor.net. Our motto is, the whole world can learn for free. This is one of the sessions of HR domain webinars. The last session we talked about performance appraisal. In this we talked about rating scales, appraisal period, then the list of items for which the rating has to be given, levels of appraisal, then self-rating, manager review, then normalization. Usually after the performance appraisal, certain things do happen. Of course, pay hikes do happen, or promotions based on the performance, promotions do happen. Let us first talk about pay. HR application must interact with payroll application. Payroll meaning how your weekly or monthly pay is processed by the company. This is part of the financial team that you have got within your company. Usually in every company, there is a term called CTC, cost to company. Right? Cost to company is anything that company spends on you. The split up of this cost to company will be like fixed to pay, variable pay. Again, if you take the fixed pay, you may see something like basic pay, house rent allowance, in certain place city allowance, right? Then there may be n number of allowances. It may be conveyance allowance, it may be food allowance, it may be even entertainment allowance, right? So, the fixed pay may have some allowance, then the variable pay may be performance based. Usually this variable pay will be based on individual performance, your group performance, then of course the company performance. They will define grades in terms of what kind of percentage the company should do for you to get that variable pay. What kind of margins your group should do, what kind of individual contribution that you do, all will be a factor within the variable pay. So the payroll department will define a table. For this person, this is the pay. And this will be accessible only to you, HR, and the payroll team. No other person can access. So the privacy and security of the system must be extremely tight when it comes to payroll or HR related information, because this is people data. There are many things personal that are stored. If they get exposed, there is a credibility problem. So the payroll department every month will give what is the pay for this person. Whenever there is a performance appraisal happening, a redefinition of pay happens, right? And along with the payroll, they will define taxes applicable. Every year, the tax codes may change depending upon the country in which you work. In certain countries, up to this is 10%. In some other countries, up to that same amount may be 12% taxable. So under each pay, basic pay or HR or city compensatory allowance or conveyance allowance, there may be some maximum limits beyond which it may be taxed, or certain taxation available, applicable throughout this pay. It changes from country to country, time to time. So the payroll department will define the new pay structure and then apply to your record in the HR system. this happens. The other thing that happens is promotions. Okay. Promotions are typically designation changes slash role changes. Most of the time people associate promotions meaning a designation change. A general manager becoming senior general manager, or an assistant vice president becoming vice president, or a technical lead becoming project manager. So there is a designation change that happens as part of promotion. So again, we have seen in the very first definition session in HR domain itself is the organization hierarchy, right? How you move in the organization hierarchy is a promotion. Upwards, not downwards, right? The downwards movement is a demotion. So we don't want demotion to anyone, but promotions do happen. So how you move up the ladder in the organization hierarchy is defined by the promotions. Again, the promotion is nothing but person A moving from designation X to Y from this date, right? So the moment a promotion do happens, this information will be saved in the HR system. At the same time, reporting structure will also change, because till yesterday you have been reporting to one manager. Now you also became manager, you may be reporting to somebody else, right? So the reporting hierarchy will also change whenever there is a promotion happening. So based upon the performance appraisals, two things are kicked off. Number one, pay change. The pay change will be done by your payroll team. That data will be available to the HR systems. It will be reflected in the HR database. Same way, if people are promoted, what is their promotion? From which level to which level they are moving? Right? That will also happen. So, this happens based on performance appraisal. Sometimes what happens is, right, there are cases where demotions also do happen. Why? Because the performance is below. Some companies will have a policy of underperformers will be asked to leave. Some companies follow that. Some companies will say, okay, you are not fit in this role, so you better play a role below that. There is a famous theory called everyone rises to the level of inefficiency. This is one of the very, very famous concept. People cannot be getting promoted every year. As a sales executive, person X did phenomenally well, okay? He is promoted as a sales manager. But he did great job in sales manager post, but the moment he was made as a sales vice president, who is supposed to handle 5 different sales managers, he miserably failed. Why does it happen? That person's capacity was max at the sales manager. The person doesn't scale to the next level. This is true for everyone. This is not just for only one bad performers. Even good performers, they are good performers at that level. A scalable person will always try to exceed what is the expectation at that level, right? Now, that's why you cannot have same person winning the World Cup every year, same team winning the World Cup every year. There is a question of sustainability and scalability. So, sustain and scale. existing position you should sustain, and you should try to scale to the next level. But this is a question: who does it faster, right? Who does it faster? That person rises to next level. So the performance appraisal is an indicator within the organization how many people are really growing. It is also an indication to the organization, is the company giving opportunities for people to grow up, right? This is again very important. If the company is not giving opportunity for others to grow, then how can you expect people to excel and scale up? So the performance appraisal, when you do for 1,000 people or say 500 people, you could see who are all the star performers, who moves to the next level. If you don't give next level to anyone, is your company stagnating from growing? So it's a serious indication to the senior management, right? So the performance appraisal is a key factor to assess people. There is one more thing called 360 degree appraisal. For senior people, what they do is, usually for junior people, self-assessment, then one level above they appraise. But instead, for some managers, for example, a general manager is there. General manager does self-appraisal. At the same time, his or her manager does maybe VP does appraisal. They do one more thing that is called a 360 appraisal. People reporting to him or her will also appraise. Why? Because as a man, as a general manager, how your people, your team is thinking about you in terms of your performance. Transparency. 360 degree appraisal gives more transparency. In some countries, the teachers, school teachers, also should write exams periodically. Why? That ensures that the teacher is also good. They are also continuously upgrading their skills. Same way, if you are in the management position, there will be a 360 degree appraisal that will be done on you. Again, not every organization does this. Some very transparent organizations do this 360 degree appraisal. But all the appraisals will lead to either pay related stuff or promotion related stuff. So I will stop this session here. We will continue other things in the next session. Thank you.